For acusports.com, Zach Carlisle, joined by head coach Joe Golding, ACU Men's Hoops. They get their 10th win of the season, 76-55, over Southeastern Louisiana here tonight. And, hey, coach, 55 points given up, just 36% shooting you gave up. How proud are you of the way your defense played?
I'm really proud because I know how good Southeastern is. Southeastern's got a really good team. They're very well coached. They're very, very good on the defensive end, and then they're hard to guard on the offensive end. And I thought a big key to the game was us getting stops on the defensive end where they couldn't set up their pressure. Their pressure is as good as anybody in our league. So I thought when we were able to get stops, we didn't have to see their press as much. So I thought our guys were really locked into it. We had all week to prepare. So obviously we had an advantage. Southeastern had to play Wednesday night and travel here, and we played like a team that had a bye week and was ready to go. So I was excited about the way we've played this back-to-back now that we've gotten back to how we want to play a little bit defensively, and so excited for our guys on that end of the floor. And then offensively, I thought we shared the basketball as good as we've shared it in a while. You know, I thought that was the strength of this team early on in the season. It hasn't been the last two or three weeks. We haven't shared the basketball as well. It's been a big point of emphasis this bye week, and I thought our guys carried that over tonight to the game.
Well, and over the last two games now, you're getting off to 13-2 leads right away in both of those games. How impressed are you the way your team's coming out right out of the gates from opening jump?
Yeah, you know, anytime you can come out and jump somebody, it obviously helps. But it's college basketball. You guys watch games all the time. Leads don't mean anything that early. You know, you got shot clock, got three-point line, you got really good players and good coaches. And so I thought credit to our guys. We maintained that lead and we built that lead, and that was because our bench came in and played great. They had the best week of practice they've had all year. In fact, they were better than our starters all week in practice, and I thought that carried over to the game. We were able to extend the lead when we went to our bench. We were able to rest some guys and stay fresh on both ends of the floor, and I thought that was a big key to the game. So as long as our bench continues to get better, I think that's going to be a big plus with us moving down the stretch.
Yeah, I think maybe a lot of people are coming in wondering how deep this team was going to be. You had 13 players play, 12 of them scored tonight. Pretty good number.
Yeah, absolutely. And we've got, you know, I trust everybody on that roster, and I mean that, but we have to have guys going in the and playing minutes for the right reasons. There's a way we want to play, and I think sometimes when you're not playing, when you get the opportunity to play, sometimes you make some mistakes because you're trying too hard or you're doing some things that we really don't care about. Like we don't need you to score the basketball. We need you to play within our offense and play within our defense and how we want to play. When you do the right things, good things happen. And I think all week of practice, they set the tone with making the extra pass and moving the ball. The black team couldn't guard them, you know, all week because of that. And I think the black team moved the basketball better because of what the white team was doing. And so. I was really impressed. We got great minutes with those guys. We've gotten good minutes from those guys. It just hasn't been as consistent as we want. And that's the same with our stars. We're always in search of consistency with this group. But I thought tonight was really good. I think that's the best that we have played overall from 1 to 13 on our team. And so extremely impressed. When you do that and everybody gets to play and you share the basketball and you guard like that, basketball is a lot of fun.
When you have as big of a three-game road trip that was coming up, how important was this one tonight?
Yeah, I didn't know we had a three-game road trip. We do.
One game at a time, right?
One game at a time, Zach. One game. We can talk to Sam now. But, yeah, it's going to be a brutal stretch. We're playing three really good basketball teams, but that's enough talk about that. We got Sam Houston State next. They beat us twice last year. They deserve our full attention. Coach Hooten and his staff, we've got tremendous respect for them. We know what kind of players they have. They got great players. They're going to compete for a Southland Conference championship. They're going to be in the mix all year long. They'll be in the mix at KD. And if we want to be in the mix, then we have to go down there and compete. I'll tell you this. I told our guys after the game, we're going to have to play the best game we've played all year just to give ourselves a chance to win. A lot of guys in our locker room haven't been down there. They don't know that, you know, and they don't know what's coming. So we've got, a couple days, two or three days here to prepare to get locked into Sam. And we're, again, going to have to play our best basketball to give ourselves a chance to win the last 4 minutes. So it's like that way night in and night out. So I think that's why you really truly have to go next game mentality, trust the process. It's a marathon, not a sprint. There's a lot of basketball left to play. We protected home court except for the McNeese game. We did our job. But then you can say we didn't do our job, you know, losing to McNeese. And now we got to go back on the road and go see if we can get one.
One game at a time. They got that one game at a time done here tonight. 76-55, ACU 10-7, and now 5-1 to start Southland Conference play. For Joe Golding, Zach Carlisle for ACUSports.com.